Hey Tim,
what am I doing? Something came up. Somebody wants to have this old 1977 illustration made, but with my way of coloring things. You know, texture and color and everything the way I do it, but with, you know, the drawing. So first thing first, I'm tracing the drawing, which is kind of boring, but it's a must. Hey Vitavix. Oh yeah. Looks, it's gonna look sick because I'm already, you know, I have this drawing for a while now. That's not gonna be an improvisation, it's gonna be like something else. Yeah. It's gonna be a foggy background, I guess. But the original colored version will have nothing to do with what I'm gonna do. Because it's not the first time I'm doing this kind of job, and the thing I know is that even though I'm gonna keep the drawing line like it is, the drawing is gonna look completely different. Alright, that's the first pass. I'm gonna have to do this three times. First time there. Second time, I'm gonna add the pencil behind that tracing paper. Attends, the sound is gonna have to calm down, you sound. Thank you. Can trust you with that for sure. Or you know, you're known for doing better than it's gonna be interesting to see if I can manage to have this, you know, photograph quality on illustration like that. I don't think so, but we'll see where we're going with that now. HB, we need something stronger than that. Hey, 4B is better. Now I'm gonna have to retrace everything again. So just that, just redoing the exact drawing. Take already a long time, cause I'm gonna trace everything, so I can't be more you know, can't be no less fidel than that. Comment ça va, Witavix? Ça va mieux? On décalque aujourd'hui. Bonsoir, bonsoir. Usually I'm doing this kind of stuff. Out of camera, not really tracing, but preparing the drawing. But I felt like, as today I'm tracing, that can be good to show my tracing technique, because I'm not sure everybody does the same. It's a bit tedious, but you're sure to capture the original drawing pretty precisely. The only problem is that you have to do that three times. I wish my light tablet could be strong enough to go through the drawing paper so I don't have to do that, but it's not the case. It's not big enough for that drawing, because at first the client wanted to have a smaller version. So then I said, you know, smaller, that we want that won't look good. You need bigger. So I can really play around with texture and volume and really make it look good. So right there it's A2. A little bit less than A2, so it's 4 printing paper, and even there I guess it's just, you know, the smallest I can do to get good result. I wish I can go bigger, but Is the neck doing better? The neck? Right down top we have Gandalf almost completely, so that's where I'm gonna start. And all the vines and everything. Gandalf the Grey. His blue hat. I like this 70s style of illustration. Did I miss something or did I just didn't listen yesterday? You have a neck problem, Tim? Yesterday I was not really in there, so sorry if I missed that. Now I need to decide which color I'm gonna do Gimli. Red is, yeah, maybe it will be red. Yeah, Legolas is gonna be green, that's easy. Oh yeah, I remember that conversation. Thank you. Elle en est où ta peinture, Weetabix? Ok, je pense qu'on est bon. Now, let's do it again on the actual sheet of paper now. Exciting process. I think I'm just gonna trace Gandalf for now. I'm gonna leave the rest for later. Otherwise, I'm gonna spend my whole evening tracing. And that's not fun. As you see, I'm using two different colors, so I know where I did pass and where I didn't pass. That's something I kind of made up, especially when you do kind of detailed tracing. Very easy to forget something. Back in the day, things were much more simple. Fantasy vibe, the genre was just gaming popularity, so gnomes and elves in medieval setting were enough. Nowadays, you got to try harder to impress people. I mean, I know that I'm doing stuff old school, cause that I like that vibe. And what I discover is that kids that come to my workshop seem to like that kind of drawing as well. So and I guess, you know, it make things really, you know, really two separate things. You know, you have the video games and then you have the board games. And I feel like, you know, in everybody's mind, it's two very different worlds, and people are okay with that kind of illustration for, you know, tabletop games. I'm still wondering if I'm gonna do the beard completely, like, or if I'm gonna do the beard, because on the sketch we can see that maybe the idea was that the beard is transforming into a mist or a fog, but I see on the colored version it's really a beard, so I'm wondering which direction I'm gonna take, because both are tempting. Very tempting to do this beard texture on him. But it's very tempting as well to make like magic begin, and he's creating a fog that starts from his beard. I feel like it looks more interesting. Look at that, 36 minutes already and I'm still tracing. Yeah, it is actually, and especially if you want to be precise. So what bothers me is all those table marks I'm making on my table, but that should be okay later. This Gondor helmet is way too simple. And I don't know if there is gonna be something I can do about it, because adding detail will change the drawing itself. So But I'm tempted to add stuff in the metal of that helmet. Looks a way too simple. Gondor is supposed to be like big, huge. No, I mean, drawing wise, I'm not supposed to change anything. It's just texture wise and color wise. But the drawing has to stay the same. It's like I'm just coloring it my way. But I guess adding detail on the helmet is not gonna change the drawing. So I may do it anyway. We'll see when I start warming. I mean, I bother because I like it. So I don't mind changing, you know, a little bit in here, a little bit in there. Alright, I guess we can trace everything now. Okay. Right, we have our first scan. Okay, I'm gonna scan up. Just not easy of coloring nails. Oh yeah, I think it's been a good month now. Maybe even more. When what was? It was just before Halloween or just after Halloween. Yeah, I was invited to a birthday party and I dressed up as a biker orc. And I put my nails in black, and then the next day I take them off. And it was really boring looking. So I say, you know what? I think I'm gonna keep my nails black. Because it looks less boring to look at. That's where the fun stuff begin. How can think? I'm gonna take off a little bit of that. We're gonna start with the brown. If I found it, where is that brown? Or we can use that one. Okay, let's do that. Nilo. I'm wondering if I will see what I'm doing. We'll see that later. I don't know. Now we need to decide where the sun is coming from. Apparently it's coming from the right, so I'm gonna keep that in mind. Remind me of the time when a fun event was staged at our university. Several teams competed in different tasks. One of them was to do a full makeup on somebody with eyes covered by a blindfold. Oh, come on. So was that somebody who got blindly covered makeup, and then I decided to go home without washing it off. Take me an hour to ride home on the metro train, so to speak. Do you have a picture? I want to see a picture now. Alright, so now this dude needs to look badass. So we're gonna take our time. What color for the eye? Put some. Yeah, it's still a bit small, but we're gonna manage it. I do, because the part of the challenge was to upload a picture with that makeup to all your social network. And the funny thing is, I don't keep any photo of myself in my page and never update my profile. There is nothing beside my name. So when I upload it, all the people I had in friends, former classmates, school teachers and etc. could see it. For an hour, only then we were allowed to delete it. That's not very kind. It could be more focused than that. That's a little bit better. Oh yeah, this guy, I remember him from school. He was like doing powerlifting and curl disassembled and assembled an egg in less than 40 seconds. Listening to metal. I wonder how he's doing. Upload the picture. Thank you. Something is missing in there. It's big, bushy eyebrows. Almost forget those. Gonna need a stronger blue. Thank you. Alors, qu'est-ce qui manque? Un peu de jaune. Un peu de rouge. Careful, that green color line, careful. Of course, I forgot a little bit of the skin here. I wonder if we'll even play D&D with my old group now, because one of the players won't be able to play for this whole month, and we kinda need our whole team, our whole party, for the tournament arc. Oh, crap. I guess it's gonna be up to your DM. Maybe something happened to that dude. Can you imagine? Really? Let's draw some beard again. Thank you for yesterday, actually. Your idea to draw something that represents my mood helped me pretty well after the Sophie Marceau's drawing. studies and his character can be excluded from the tournament because we have NPCs. Oh yeah, I also saw that you decided to go. Merry Christmas. Yeah, I mean, that was working, and actually, yeah, that was not that a big deal because nobody really care about that that sketch. Now he's on my Patreon. So we'll be available for those that are my Patreon subscribers. So every month I'm gonna pick up a name from my Patreon's sub, and they will win a drawing that is on my Patreon page, the one they want. And those drawings are the drawings I made during my drawing workshops that I do with my students. Those drawings are just made for accompanying, you know, the students. So just, they are not really commissioned, they are not really, you know, drawing that I really want to do. It's just exercise and, you know, to studies and stuff like that, or sketches sometimes. Yeah, I mean, it was not, you know, you were not targeted. I'm just saying out loud, so if people are interested, they can check it out. I found a cool way to use those drawings, so somebody can have them for like €3 a month. You have a pretty good chance to get a drawing, because right now I have like one subscriber. So if it stay like that for January, it is almost certain to win a drawing. And the funny story is that my only subscribers is coming every Tuesday on my workshop. He's one of my students. If I can call him a student, because he's a math teacher. So I have a really hard time to call him a student. He's more like a dude that come to know how to draw. Because I'm not really a teacher. Yeah, something that is quite missing on that sketch is the shadows. There is a little bit of shadows on the sketch, but not everything is as in the shadow that it should be. Because it's a big hat, you know, his face is almost all covered up with that shadow. And I don't really mind to see only one side of his face. I think it looks cool. The link is already on my bio, but I don't know if there is enough people there that, you know, make any point of point it out. I keep talking about it in my Facebook, and I have quite a lot of people over there. I talked about it on my Discord. I talked about it on my Instagram. Doesn't seem to interest anybody, because I guess nobody have money for that. I don't know. Or maybe my work is not good enough for, you know, people being interested. From that point, I stopped wondering why, what others try that's working is not really working when I'm trying to do it. Because I have a curse with internet, so it's been, you know, from the beginning I started my business, I never got really successful with internet. All the commission I have usually is coming from around, not the internet. So internet is just for me a nice way to show what I can do, but I never get, you know, any money from it. A little bit here and there, but that's...
Well, you are relatively obscure through the busiest it gets here is about... Yeah. It's not that.
And it's been like, what, 2 years? 2 years on Twitch. I didn't get the 600 yet. And yeah, usually at best we are 12. So you see right there that, you know, I'm not on Twitch to earn money. I'm just here to talk with you guys, that's all. Yeah, I like that face, and that hat is coming along pretty good. It's actually pretty fun to do. That's why I wanted to do it now, because, you know, I spend more than 25 hours to do the Sophie Marceau's drawing. As you know, it's pretty pretty awesome and it looks, it's quite boring to do. But right there, it's funnier because you're trying to apply those color and technique on an illustration to improve it. That's much way more fun, and the subject is way more fun. And I'm quite interesting to see the end result. And I will have a pretty awesome illustration to hang in my workshop. Told you a while ago, to get somewhere in here, you need to work hard. It doesn't happen on its own. In most cases, networking, collaboration, promotion, and many other cool and business sounding things I learned in my university and grown. But at least I can at least understand what's up. Yeah, I mean, probably, yeah, you probably know better than I do. And you're right, I don't really feel like doing all those things. And I guess that's why I gave up. I can't really say gave up because that was not the goal anyway. But I stopped wondering why, because you told me, like you say, a long time ago, why. So I don't really need to know more. Now I'm just hoping that some dude is gonna pop out and we can talk for 2 or 3 hours. Most of the time it's you, and a lot of the time is, you know, like the other day was Vitavix, and back in some, you know, and before that we are, yeah, there is a lot of different people that come and go and have a chat a little bit, and that's pretty why I'm do that on Twitch, so I can have fun with illustration, because otherwise, look, if I wouldn't be drawing a cool story right now, what I would have done, I would have probably watching TV and probably watch, you know, an episode on Netflix or something, losing like 2 or 3 hours of my evening, when I can use that time and draw cool stuff and keep working my skill while talking with people. So yeah, I much prefer that. Sometimes, of course, sometimes I don't really feel like drawing, so that's why I'm watching Netflix and try to empty my head with a stupid episode of some sort. But yeah, I much prefer having a draw with you guys. Now, we need to think about texture for that hat. I don't want to have flat colors, I want to have, like, you can feel the texture of that. What's the name of that? Felt? Is that the name in English? What this hat is made of? Felt, I think it is. Feutrine. So I want to implement, take a degree of business to start hating it. Tools to be told, some days I really want to move north and be like a country English teacher. Maybe it's a good idea. You need to go where your heart is telling you to go. Sometimes the brain and the heart is not really happy with each other. And but I know that it's always better to follow your heart than your brain. feel it really. It's better. Maybe financially it's not that good. But spiritually it's better to follow your heart. From my side, where it, what is it? Quelques dessins. Quel dessin trouves-tu le plus compliqué, la princesse ou celui-ci? Hey Bianca. There are not. Il n'y en a pas un qui est plus compliqué que l'autre. Il y en a un qui est plus rigolo. Celui-ci est plus rigolo à faire. It's more fun. The other one was just, you know, applying color. I mean, it's kind of what I'm doing here, but it's easier. It's funnier. It's more, much more enjoyable. Because with the queen, all you do is just printing with your hand the picture. But right there, I have to decide what color I'm gonna apply, which texture I'm gonna do, you know, what shadows, and I need to make a lot of different decisions. And those decisions gonna change the look of that drawing. Tell me on Messenger, Bianca, if you heard the answer. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to type down what I just said.
Just not cut from a cool and promising business career, full of traveling and whatnot. But on the other hand, so much was sacrificed and invested in me getting a proper education. I just feel like I need to try. It's not like I don't have interesting business ideas or concepts, it's just that I really don't have a burning passion and will do anything, never mind risking probably and money, yeah,
property and money, yeah. I mean, if you have nothing better to do than your business plan, just what you're studying, just keep going.
Alors, la question c'est quelle couleur je vais faire ça. Il me semble dans la description de Tolkien, on parle de d'écharpe argentée. Then I'm gonna play with that.
Hey, Mr. Seeker, greeting from Dubai Airport. Hey. Oh, you coming back now? Yeah, I think I'm gonna keep the idea of that beard transforming into a mist. Because I have really hard time to picture a really long beard that long. And as it was the idea of this sketch, I think I'm gonna keep it. Looks cooler. Yeah, it will add a little bit of magic from Gandalf. Actually, he's doing something. And so I can put a little bit of mist and have a gray sky behind him. So gray, I'm achieving gray with light blue and brown or pink, and adding the color I want in my gray. And in that case, it's gonna be this greenish yellow, because I want my Gandalf to be quite, you know, dirty and on the road for a while, a little bit like in the movie. I don't want, you know, a nice, pristine wizard. I want him to be a little bit beat up. Always look more interesting. The elf, I guess the only one that's gonna look pretty nice and clean will be the elf, of course. And, you know, I'm saying that, but I'm not even convinced that it's what I'm gonna do. But on the original image, you know, the color flat, everything, you know, nothing really happened. And the sketch, that's why I found the sketch way more powerful than the final coloring version. So it's often the case. The sketch always look a little bit better those days. And the beauty of what I'm doing with the colored pencil, colored ballpoint pen, is that we keep that, you know, that sketchy looking, like a gravure kind of thing. But you push it far enough. So it looks pretty realistic. So that's gonna be the gray of this coat, but darker. I want to have, because in a book Tolkien described Gandalf with a silver scarf. So I guess that's the closest we have in that illustration of a scarf. So I'm gonna keep it gray, like silver gray, and then I'm gonna do the cloak much darker and beat up. There is one thing I want to do with that picture, is taking my time. Enjoy it and put as much as I can in there. Because why not? I don't have much more to do anyway. Sadly, for now, I get bored of my Orc versus Dwarfs illustration. So I'm gonna concentrate myself on that one for now. And just having fun. I'm not gonna touch this platinum blonde head for now, I'm gonna keep it for later. Putting a lot of effort in secondary things. I make a lot of memories for our D&D group based on our adventure, and even though no more than 7 people will be there, will see them, I still can waste up to 3 hours editing and sealing a silly image in hopes it will make someone giggle. Yeah, I mean, as long as we have fun, it time you spend on it, it doesn't matter, because all that time you were enjoying yourself. And that's what I'm doing right now. I still remember that one I made for your for you when you made a typo and said you will stream for 19 hours straight. Did I say I will stream for 19 hours? I don't think it's even possible. I stream for 12 hours. Hey Barlow, on my break at work, welcome, welcome. Today we are coloring somehow. Oh yeah. Today I'm taking a really old illustration. And just coloring it my way to make it even more cool. Is this commission or fun? It's both. It's both commission and fun. It's a fun commission.
That dude wants to have that old illustration being made, you know. The only thing I have to do is to keep the original drawing. The rest is up to me. And of course, the dude didn't ask me to use paint or fiber pencil or colored pencil. No. You don't ask the only ballpoint pen orc artist on Twitch to use something else than his ballpoint pen. Nonsense. You guys saw my trailer? I put a trailer on my page. If we can call that a trailer. It's more like, you know, a welcoming message in case I'm not streaming. Twitch, yeah, I saw it, I was weirded out. What the hell, it just turned the screen for half a minute, said to stay tuned and was gone. Yeah.
Yeah, I try to do something that look like me. Yeah, I guess I'm not, you know, I'm not mistaken saying that I'm the only board pumping orc artist on Twitch. Because apparently I'm not the only one who do board pumping, that's one thing. I'm still, you know, looking for those guys. I have one or two already, but not the same way that I do it. I'd be really pleased to find Twitch board porn print artists that do that all, you know, full time. Come on, can't you stay over there? Is that that hard to stay over there? Thank you. Come on, there we go. Yeah, I'm back in the time where the dude did draw that drawing. Yeah, he didn't know that like 40 something years later that character would be famous for saying "you shall not pass." Cause that's what I hear now when I see that dude screaming. Oh yeah? I'm surprised. I thought you liked fantasy.
stuff. Why is that? Is that because it's those kind of situation where you hear so much about it that you don't want to see it anymore? Because it happened to me with Titanic. I never saw Titanic. Because of that. Been working, beautiful work. Thank you very much, thanks, Angel. Not a big movie guy. Used to the cinema of watching something in a social thing you do with friends. Don't really have that. I mean, I do have both of them. It's just that it's never been a thing. So I usually watch thing only on YouTube in my proud solitude. I mean, it's too late to watching in cinema anyway, so maybe you should consider watching those movies in your own little computer, in your own little privacy. It's good fantasy stuff. And I think everybody will agree that it's the best fantasy. I mean, it's funny enough, Peter Jackson didn't want a two fantasy movie. That's the only thing that I missed in that movie, actually. Because a little bit of this, of the magic and the fantasy, and you know what make the Lord of the Ring a fantasy world is a little bit missing on the movie, because you have every element of Eric fantasy. You have wizards, you have trolls, orcs, goblins, wargs, stuff like that, but it's made in such a way that it looks more like history, you know, It's more seriously made, which is good because it looks serious and legit. But you missed a little bit of the style that is behind fantasy games, for example. I would love, for example, which is not doable anymore because the movie has been made, but I will have loved to see like an an animated movie, you know, a stylized this kind of stylization of the movie with nice, you know, nice texture and everything, but more, you know, much more anchor into magic and stuff. Peter Jackson didn't want to see any magic in his movies. And it's too bad. I really like magic. So used to the idea of it being done with somebody, despite almost never doing so. So I don't watch movie or series. Okay. I mean, that's your choice. I really like to escape from time to time from reality and watch a nice movie that, you know, make you forget where you are for 2 hours. Alright, I need a stronger color, so I'm gonna keep going. I need a stronger gray than the scarf. That's what I need. Is that you, Bianca? Yeah, ding 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 ding, no. Bum ba-dum bum bum.
Okay, I need a classic blue, or maybe this one. Maybe this one is a little bit stronger. So to get a gray with ballpoint pen, it's really about the balance between that blue and that brown. So the both color don't have to be stronger than the others. You know, if it's too blue, we need brown. If it's too brown, you need blue. But you know, it's both color that gonna make the gray. Used to do it with pink, to pink as well, but it works pretty well with brown. I guess it's the red color inside that make it works. And then it's about, you know, putting another color in there, like a greenish yellow, like I'm doing now. Right now we almost, it's the same color than the scarf, so I need to keep going. It's not dark enough. Okay. It's starting to get there. Thank you for the follow, Nasty. Welcome, welcome. We do colorization today. Keeping the drawing as it is, but just changing the colors. I'm doing it my way today. So I guess we can maybe... silver as well? I'm wondering what color I'm gonna do. Those leaves, maybe blue, like the hat. I'm hesitating between the silver and the... What's funny is that I'm gonna have to do it that again in the other side and try to find the same color. I should do both in the same time, but I really want to know where I'm going with that color. Okay, I think it's darker now, so the scarf can be seen pretty better. Now, the question is, what's the color of that thing there? Is that thing silver, maybe? Maybe I can do a rough, like, texture on the outside and, like, a shiny texture in the inside, like it's some kind of velvet. That's where is this project is fun, because I need to figure out and decide what is what. You know, what is that shiny? Is that matte? You know, is that metal? Is that, what kind of texture is this? You know what I mean? And that's what I'm getting me excited in that project. It's all those decisions I need to make it, you know, to make that illustration mine, to go beyond what this dude was doing in 1977. Yeah, I mean, I'm in a position now that I can do pretty what I want. So I just need to decide what material is gonna be. And I'm up for making a silver velvet inside for Gandalf. Cloth. I'm not sure it's appropriate, but it's kind of what I feel like to do right now. To get back to this, you know, wizard feeling. Pretty awesome, actually. starting to grab a little bit of the pencil. Okay, it's better. What about something like that?
Yeah, I think
I'm gonna leave it. Almost wait. What's that? Come on. That was not there before. Shit. Okay, never mind. That's a too big piece of paper for my disk. That's when you watch this illustration, you're like, wow, Gandalf has a huge hand. His hand is double the size of Legolas' head. Yeah, I was thinking it could be a good idea, or maybe not white, but I was thinking about silver velvet, something like that. So I'm still, you know, going around that shiny silver velvet texture. Merci Volred. Salut tout le monde. Hello, hello Raiders. Hello Hiroshi. Hello Les Faust. Shanini. Bienvenue, bienvenue. Bonsoir. Futokshbourg. Ce soir on fait de la colorisation. En fait, c'est un petit peu le même principe que les figurines. Je prends une figurine qui existe déjà et je la repeins avec des stylos. Voilà, tu vois, dans le même état d'esprit que ce que tu voulais avec ton Goku. Voilà, il y a quelqu'un qui le voulait avec cette illustration là. Garde le dessin, mais fais-le à ta façon. J'ai les photos que je voulais, je te contacte dans la semaine. Ok, cool. C'est C'était pour Noël, je me rappelle plus. Pour Noël ou pour l'anniversaire? Parce que ça va commencer à devenir chaud là. Ah, mars, ça va. Tout à coup, j'ai cru que c'était pour Noël. Je me suis dit, oh, ça commence à être chaud. J'aime le piment d'Espelette. Ouais, c'est bien. Ah, il a quoi, l'accent, il a un accent du sud. J'aime bien le piment d'Espelette. Ok. Bon fruit. Ok, bon, je pense qu'on est bon de ce côté. Bon, bah, on va passer de l'autre côté. Ce qui est rigolo avec cette illustration, c'est de repenser toutes les textures, en fait. Toutes les textures, toutes les couleurs. Décider quelle couleur est quoi, est-ce que c'est mat, est-ce que c'est brillant. Bon, mais il n'y a plus qu'à refaire la même chose de l'autre côté du coup. Super. Quelle heure il se fait? Oh, bah il est déjà minuit. Thank you. right, it's getting a bit late around here. Catch you later, and it's been a pleasure like always. It's been a pleasure for me too, my friend. I'll see you pretty soon. Thank you for coming, as usual. And see you next time. Alors, la barbe. L'idée de la barbe, c'est de reprendre l'idée qu'il y a sur le croquis et qu'il n'y a plus sur le dessin colorisé. Et là, sur le croquis, la barbe a l'air de se transformer un petit peu en brouillard. Et ça va rajouter un petit peu de magie dans ce... dans cette représentation de Gandalf. Donc je vais le garder. Pouvoir monter un petit peu là.
Hop.
There we go. Madame Hébert, bonsoir. Petite question. Quand on a 20 quais et qu'on les utilise pour la commission, envoie-t-il l'original par la poste lorsque c'est fini? Oui. Je sais que ça peut prendre plus qu'une séance. Oui, 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 j'envoie. Au début, je le faisais pas et après. Et après, je me suis dit, en fait, ça prend tellement de temps à finir une commande, c'est que du coup, c'est que tu as dû être là longtemps, longtemps, ou alors, ou que tu passes juste pour farmer, enfin, quoi qu'il en soit, il faut quand même être là très très longtemps pour pouvoir compléter une commande, et je pense que ça mérite d'avoir l'original, donc, tu reçois l'original, ce qui te permet de pouvoir commander même des portraits de famille, ou... Comment ça va ce soir? Ça fait peut-être déjà un petit moment que t'es là, remarque. Putain, c'est déjà l'heure. Ah bah quand on s'amuse, ça passe plus vite, hein. Je suis pas à l'abri de continuer ce dessin demain. Demain matin. Des petites courses à faire, mais après je pense que je vais revenir continuer ce dessin. Changer un peu la nature des plis qu'il y a sur le croquis d'origine parce que sinon ça n'a aucun sens. Oui, depuis le début du mage. Ok. Je me suis rendu compte que peindre la maison de mon ami, que c'est plus dur sur les jambes que je croyais. Ah oui, bah, quand on n'a pas l'habitude de faire ce genre d'activité. Et encore, les jambes, moi, je trouve que ça va. Ce qui est plus dur pour moi, c'est les bras, les épaules. Ça dépend ce que tu as à peindre. Je te souhaite de ne pas avoir besoin de peindre le plafond. Le plafond, c'est mortel. Mortel le plafond. Donc le mage en question s'appelle Gandalf. Je vais vous laisser bonne nuit Letfaos. Merci beaucoup d'être passé et d'avoir d'être resté un petit peu. Ah bah oui, je viens de lire le titre du dessin à côté. Ouais. Bah oui. C'est un vieux dessin dessiné par Raymond là, et t'as le titre en haut du gars. Là, quelque part. Par là, là, ici. Je sais pas si on le voit bien, ouais. C'est un vieux dessin de. C'est un vieux dessin de 1977 que j'aime beaucoup. Finalement, mes favoris de nains, c'était vraiment cool dans l'ensemble de costumes. Attends. Ah bien oui, attends, j'ai raté un truc là. Finalement, mes favoris de nains, c'était vraiment cool dans l'ensemble du costume. Ah oui! C'est-à-dire qu'elle. Je crois qu'il manque un bout en fait. Tu parles de tes rajouts? T'as des photos de qu'on peut voir? Que tu peux mettre. Oui, les prothèses, oui. T'as des photos ou tu veux garder ça pour toi? Une, ça suffit, hein. Ça suffit une pour voir ce que ça donne. Ah, attends, j'entends un tigling, ce serait pas toi? Aussi. Ah ouais, ça le fait trop, hein. Ça le fait bien. GG. Alors, c'est cool d'être une dwarf. Ce morceau de robe avant d'aller me coucher. Je vais planifier la construction d'une galerie souterraine dans le village. Y'a me dwarf and digging a hole. Dig a hole. Tu sais que j'ai réécrit cette chanson pour mon personnage du Bard Orc. Parce que je suis en train de me faire un personnage de Bard Orc. Et J'ai réécrit cette chanson avec un orque. Je suis un orque et je chante comme un trou. En fait, toutes les chansons que j'aime bien, tous les airs que j'aime bien, je suis en train de les transformer pour mon répertoire. J'ai transformé de Wellerman as well. Yov est une femelle dans mon village. Quand tu l'as croisée, ça s'appelle fromage. Des crocs bien jaunes, des cheveux de gnome. Ah ouais, qu'elle était belle. Tu veux savoir la suite, hein? C'est de la beauté orque, mais c'est d'une poésie incroyable. Les gens ne se rendent pas compte. Une belle chanson d'amour. Alors, faut que je fonce encore, c'est toujours... Alors les petits coups, c'était de la texture. Ouais, j'essaye un petit peu de mettre une différence de texture entre le manteau extérieur et l'intérieur du manteau. Ce dessin, c'est que ça en fait. C'est couleur, texture, volume. Voilà ce que je rajoute, qui n'existe pas. Parce que bon, le Gandalf, il voyage, hein. Donc son manteau, il est... endommagé par l'aventure, exactement. C'est un peu ça que j'ai envie de donner, ça. Et en même temps, quand même, lui garder un petit côté magique, c'est pour ça que je lui ai fait les... Je lui laisse quand même l'intérieur un peu argenté. Même si, bon, je vais faire quand même des petites taches ici et là, au bout d'un moment, quand même, parce que, bon... Pas que ce soit trop propre non plus. Ok, je pense qu'on n'est pas trop mal. On est à peu près la même couleur que l'autre côté. Je vais rajouter un petit peu de... Ce sera tout pour ce soir. Ça fait déjà presque 4 heures. Par contre, ce qui est clair, c'est que je vais sûrement revenir demain matin parce que j'ai trop envie de continuer. J'ai trop envie de voir la suite. C'est trop cool. Oups, pas la bonne couleur, shit. Faut qu'il ait l'air un peu délavé, quoi. Ok, c'est tout pour ce soir. That's it for this evening. I'll be back with that drawing tomorrow. That's for sure. Ton matin, ça veut dire plus ou moins quelle heure? Demain matin. Alors, je pense que ce que je vais faire, c'est que je vais me faire mes petites courses dès 9h30 le matin, heure française. Je sais pas, vers 10h, 10h30. Je vais streamer genre 2 heures. Après je mange et après j'ai des ateliers. J'ai des ateliers après donc j'aurai plus le temps. Mais demain matin, ouais, deux petites heures histoire de continuer parce que là il est trop cool en fait. Je savais que ça allait être cool mais je savais pas que ça allait être cool à ce point là en fait. Et c'est que le début. C'est que le début. Donc ouais, je dirais vers 10h30. Si tout va comme j'ai envie. On va aller raider quelqu'un. Et puis on va aller se coucher. Bonne nuit tout le monde. Good night everybody. Thank you for coming. Merci d'avoir fini la soirée avec moi. Et à bientôt. Salut. Bye.
So here's the sort of from the 30,000 foot overview, like the immediate vibe that it gave me was Voldemort, Dementor, which is like all that I love. Dude, I love, love, love this. I think this is one of your stronger silhouettes that you've made. Sir, I think also limiting the color palette to this neutralish, warmish gray, kind of this brownish gray.
I'm Tony Wheeler.